$15 a piece, 2 for $25, you can get all 3 for $30. That's a pretty good deal.
Four for $40, 5 for $50.
Yeah, yeah. We're trying original tune here. How many of y'all from West Virginia? Well, how many is your first time here in West Virginia? We've all been here before.
Oh, well, good.
I was going to tell you, that's okay as long as you got here as fast as you could. So, this is called West Virginia Line.
Yeah.
So this will be by Houston Sanders on the five string. Levi, I realized right away that he had a special knack for the banjo soundings of Don Reno, and not a lot of banjo pickers seem to be able to replicate the styles of Don Reno. And I think the reason is because it's not easy.
Oh, you're too kind.
Well, people get so stuck in styles. You know, like the most common banjo style you're going to hear, obviously, is the Earl Scruggs three finger method. The other style would be the clawhammer style banjo, which is a strumming style with no picks. And then there's like regional styles from all over the country and all over the world, really. And Don Reno was very unique in the 1950s. He came onto the scene and he played it with one of the unique things about Don Reno is that he played the banjo without a caper. He didn't use a caper, which is this little device here that we strap onto the neck to get different positions, so you can play certain chord structures in different keys. Don Reno didn't use one, so he had a more of a jazz approach to his playing. I think you'll hear that right away.
It's because he knew how to play. He didn't need a caper.
That's probably what it was. He knew how to play and didn't need a caper. I talked it out too. So we're going to try this here. This is an old vaudeville tune that Don Reno in the 1950s recorded, and it immediately it became, in the bluegrass world, the banjo world, a Reno standard. This is called Whispering.
Yeah. Well, thank you for that fabulous introduction. Yeah, this is one of my all-time favorite tunes. Did you already say it came from the 1920s?
Well, it was a vaudeville tune.
Yeah, you already beat me to it. Yeah. All right, great. Oh, here we go. Yeah, Whispering. It's a lovely song. If you have a significant other, it's a lovely song to dance.
If you know how to do like the
fox trot or the Charleston, yeah. Charleston is left, left, right, right, left, back. Charleston. Here we go. Whispering.
Whispering.
Let's swing it a little. Oh, I can't.
Whispering.
Thank you.
Houston Senator is going to try to shoot a man.
See? Thank you.
It's about time to get my beautiful wife, Jamie Lynn, to sing something.
Finally!
She, I may be a little biased. She's my favorite part of the show. Robbie said she's the only reason he came tonight. Took her out for a little while. Took us both out for a little while. We had to take a completely different direction in life for a little while. And we're getting back to whatever the new normal is. The good news is she's had some major scans done here recently, and everything came back. No evidence of disease. So. She's starting to get her strength back, and she never once lost that wonderful, beautiful, smiling personality. She kept a smile on her face the whole time. She was a huge inspiration to me through the whole thing. Like, I am not as positive as Jamie.
You've said that
I've said this out loud many times. That, she's just sometimes just so darn positive. You know? even when normal people wouldn't be. So.
Oh,
try one here written by one of, definitely all of us, I would say, is one of our biggest influences, the late, the great Hazel Dickens, who was a West Virginia native bluegrass musician and songwriter. Familiar with Hazel Dickens. If you're not, you know, we all have these smartphones now. They're getting pretty smart. You can ask Mr. Google anything. Type in that name, Hazel Dickens, and check her out. Her life story is really cool. Her music's amazing. And we just love her. Jane Lynn's going to do this one. Hazel was kind enough to allow us to record a couple of her tunes on our first CD. And we sent her the CD, and later after she had passed away, her nephew approached us, who we'd become friends with, and he let us know that she it was funny, she called us kids. She said she was so happy to see those kids from West Virginia playing her music. And she said, you tell them that they're welcome to record any song of mine that they want, as long as we're not on a major record label. That was one of her rules. She didn't like record companies getting any of the artists' money. And then she left a note specifically to us that said, if anybody ever came looking for money for Hazel Dickens songs, to tell them that Hazel Dickens said they can stick it. And if you know anything about Hazel, that's just totally her.
Where?
Use your imagination. I assume where the sun don't shine. That's it.
Oh!
A cabinet.
That's inappropriate.
This is called West Virginia.
Stick that on that shelf.
Yeah, put that in the
pan. Stick it on that shelf
and cover it up.
Yeah. Stick that
all
in
right.
The pot. Stick that in the pipe.
Well, I'm ready whenever y'all are.
So I'm ready.
I'm ready too.
I'm in position.
We're going to play it off the tree. It's the only pretty song I play.
Thank you.
my grandfather introduced me to the music stylings of Jimmy Martin. It was one of his favorites. I remember sitting as a little boy, we used to watch those old country comedy variety TV shows together, you know, the ones that aren't on anymore. And I remember sitting with him. Now, my grandfather was a Pentecostal preacher, and he was a very soft-spoken man. And it took me by surprise. We're sitting there watching TV, and they said, "Come on up next, Jimmy Martin." And he punched me in the shoulder, and he said, "Now, you watch here, boy. You're going to see the king." And I said, "Pap, I thought the king was Elvis." He said, "No, we're talking about bluegrass here, not rock and roll." Anyway, Jimmy Martin came on, and I got what he meant about being the king of bluegrass. You know, I believe originally he was self-proclaimed the king of bluegrass.
Ryan would rather kick it up by an even number of notches.
Okay.
He said, "Hey, man."
I said we were kicking up a notch, Ryan prefers even numbers of notches.
We're going to pick a prime number instead.
Oh, prime number.
Yeah. Somebody give us a prime number.
3.1.
One.
Is one prime?
We're right
one
back
notch.
Where we started,
one
from.
Notch.
Come on.
One notch it is. Anyway, this is a song that that Jimmy Martin came on and played, and I had totally forgotten about it.
Yeah,
somebody gave us a CD about crowd of the show. This was the first song on, and it brought back all kinds of memories, and I decided right then and there, time to play. So.
One knot. Knot or
not? One knot or
not? Is this
like
a knot?
Like a knot?
One knot.
Let's just do a couple
knots. A knot.
Shiver me timbers, baby.
It's also a
one
knot.
A
couple of
knots.
Yeah, this is the most awesome song ever written by a writer.
We don't know who wrote it.
I'm not that, but here we go, hit parade of love.
Hit parade of love, yeah.
Yeah, let's hit it. Here we go, ready? One, two, three.
grandfather there earlier, and about him being a Pentecostal preacher. Being raised by a preacher means certain things in life. One is you go to church a lot, like a whole lot. And I'm not talking about for service. I'm talking about just whatever happened in that church. Say a window got broke or the roof was leaking. No matter what it was, we had to go to the church and take care of it. And, you know, my grandfather used to have a line. He'd say, get your stuff, we're going to the church. And I was, you know, I was just a little boy. I'd say, Pap, it's Saturday morning. I just want to watch cartoons. I'm a good kid. And, you know, he wouldn't let me home alone at that age. Finally, the day came when he, you know, because he told me, you got to be your own man and all that. When was that?
Like,
right before he passed away, about a year and a half ago. Finally, he let me stay home alone. You know, I got to a certain age, I got rebellious, and he decided, you know, he wasn't going to make anybody do anything they didn't want to do. You know, I got rebellious. I said, Pap, I don't want to go to church today. And he said, well, you got to be your own man. You got to make your own path in life. He said, always try to do what's right. He said, but I'd never force anybody to do anything they didn't want to do. He was a good man. But he asked me to do one thing. He's the one who got me into bluegrass music, like I said earlier. He said, you know, while you're out there playing for folks, playing that bluegrass music, he said, do me a favor. Your grandpa. He said, at least sing one song for Jesus. And I'm not the most spiritual guy in the world, but I love my grandpa. And I've kept that promise. And the best gospel song I could do, I hope y'all don't mind if I do one for my grandpa. The best gospel song I could do is You're Drifting Too Far From the Shore. I'm sure my grandpa would have agreed.
Drifting.
Start off with an old town's man's aunt. Why, Craig, honor me? Kenny Baker song. Well, not originally.
Not originally. Way over his.
The melody line of this tune started as a march, like a, you know, 76 trombone.
How many trombones?
76. I mean, one song.
Can't count that high.
76 trombones at the big parade. Kenny Baker had a way of taking any song and making it a wonderful tune, this being one of them. Originally, this song was called the Washington County March. Once Kenny Baker turned it to a field tune, he just called it Washington County. So. beard's looking healthy. He said he found a new product for it.
Yep.
Was it Amish?
Honest
Amish.
Honest
Amish. If y'all want to grow a beard like that.
Well, you know. Results may vary.
Results may vary. Changes, try to keep up.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
So happy birthday, Gary. Welcome to the birthday party.
Constant.
boys.
Well, we got married in fever. Woo! Hotter than a pepper spout. We got talking about Jackson ever since the fire went out. I'm going to Jackson. Woo! Well, that's a fact. Woo! Oh, I'm going to Jackson. Ain't never coming back.
I'm going down to Jackson. Woo! Go ahead.
Thank you.
1, 2, 3. Maybe I can't do it right now.
Just kidding.
There it is. 1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
Thank you.
looks like the old man's moving on.
Dedicated all our friends over in the UK.